I'm Helen Bauer, and Alan has asked me to entertain some of his guests before they head on to As Yet Untitled. So welcome to Bauer's Bar. I am giving you lovely people on the internet free backstage access to the green room. So pull up a stool, join us for a pre-show tipple, a little chin wag, and we will be naming one of my special As Yet Untitled mystery cocktails. Well, hello.
Sue Perkins.
Of all the bars in all the world.
Herzlich willkommen in Bauer's Bar.
I'm feeling done.
Ganz gerne. Okay, now I'm actually tempted to do the whole thing in German.
I would understand, but not be able to respond.
No, I think you would be able to respond. You're someone who says they don't speak German, but that means they actually can speak German. Little question.
Yeah.
I'm going to make you a drink. Yeah. Obviously alcohol-free, because yeah. Rumour has it.
Because I'm working.
How pissed will you get if I give you one bit of alcohol?
There's a roadmap that begins for me with the first drink and ends with me with baps out on this table.
I've got pineapple juice, cranberry juice, bramble mix. Open your
mind. Bramble mix?
I don't know if it's actually nettles.
Sounds or foraged. That's pure wee-wee and jism from a hedgerow, but I'm having it.
Have it.
I'm having
100%.
It. Just don't even bother saying anything else. Let's have
pina colada mix, passion fruit mix.
Yeah, whatever you want.
Oh my God, I'm so happy.
Like somebody who cares what I put in my mouth.
But it's because you have an experimental palate because you travel the world. You do. You have a famously experimental palate.
No, I have, and I've eaten everything. I would challenge you to find things that I haven't eaten. I've eaten a peacock. Yeah.
You can't eat peacock.
And we did. We've eaten peacock. Where? Fallopian tubes. I've eaten them. I'm not even joking.
Wait, where did you eat a fallopian tube? I mean, obviously in a womb.
In Italy.
Like...
Not in a womb. I didn't crawl into a womb and eat a fallopian tube.
How do you get access to a fallopian tube in this
really
day and
bad.
Age?
I don't know is the answer. We were doing a show where we had to eat things from the past. And the Romans used to eat sexual organs. So they were like, right, make them eat a fallopian tube. Could they find one? No. Eventually, they went to a Chinese supermarket in Soho, shipped it over, and it was full uterus and bits and bobs, and they fried it. It was awful. It was absolutely awful.
But why? Okay, I get it. When you're in a different country, you want to try their local stuff because you want to be polite.
Yeah.
But I feel like I've started drawing the line recently because I'm 31 now. I went to the Philippines.
Just a baby.
No, I'm grown up. 31 is full grown.
No.
It is. Honestly, the sag on my body is... real.
That's experience.
People
that's
talk
not
about
growing
elasticity.
Up.
My vaginal lips is I could fashion a shaft out of them.
We've gone straight to the vaginal lips.
Well, I feel like you're having an alcoholic drink. So
what
I need
is
to bring...
that?
It's
what?
A pina colada mix. You said whatever I wanted.
But that's basically milk.
Right.
You're making a latte with pineapple juice.
I'm going to level with you. I want you to have a nice time in here, but I will not be judged by a woman who had a fallopian tube for
yeah,
putting
right.
pina colada mix
you're
in
right.
drink.
You're
I feel
right.
that's mental, the jump you just made.
No. And I'm imagine really getting really annoyed about that. Yeah,
calm down.
Yeah, calm. Ich muss calm be. What is calm? What is calm?
No one knows.
What, in Germany?
You ever seen a German person chill out?
Yes, I have.
When?
In Berlin. There's so with the glasses. Yeah. Such a sense of sophistication.
What did you eat in Berlin, actually?
Oh, I had a couple of really good vegetarian sausages. The bratwursts.
The bratwursts?
It's all pork knuckle, isn't it? There's a lot of pig's
it's,
knuckle.
Right.
I didn't even know they had knuckles.
Okay, pigs have got everything. That's one thing I've learned.
Yeah, I think the pig's tail and nose.
Mingin! Why the tail, though?
Just to make people laugh, and everyone did laugh, but inside I was so sad.
I do that. I eat and drink things to show off to people.
Yeah.
And then feel like I once drank a shot of lip balm to try and show
How
off
did you liquidise that?
Like some girl did it at a party.
Did you boke? Did you chalk?
Did I boke?
Yeah.
No.
My mate ate a microwave toad in China, styled it out, but then blew chunks quite heavily all night.
I'm going to let you sit with what you just said while shaking this.
That's fine.
I went to this thing called Matlock Bath Illuminations that I'm sure you've heard of.
That sounds so good.
It is actually amazing. And on the last night of the Illuminations, there's a kind of outdoor show in the gardens. And Take That came right at the beginning of their careers. It was probably like 1990. And Mark Owen leant on an amp and picked me out of the crowd.
The literal dream.
I know, and sang this like slow song to me. And they were all in like really tight leather gear and oiled up and stuff.
Yeah, and you were losing your mind.
Absolutely,
obviously.
And we were very young. And there weren't many people in the audience either. There were like 50 of us, if that, just outside standing up. My dad had given me a pound for like chips or something. And I wanted to say thank you like you would with a busker. So I just lobbed it really hard through the air to say thank you for singing to me. And it hit him on the head. and then bounced off. And he like looked around like, who did that?
That's intense. I feel there's a lot more still to discover from you guys. Can I quickly ask you to play a game with me though?
I like that idea a lot and I think that we should do that.
Yay! Who would want to go first? I'm gonna be guessing because I'm okay. Really good at telling if people are lying because I can see through bullshit.
You go first,
Jordan. I'll do a first one.
It's a lie, you're not looking at me.
Oh, God, she's so good at this. I nearly died because I choked on a chicken bone, but I had to swallow a bottle of vinegar to get the chicken bone to go down my gullet. Another thing is that my dad invented scale electrics, the car.
Okay, yeah, that feels like a kid on the playground. So, yeah, like, my dad invented scale electrics.
Yeah, and then the other thing is that I can't see out of one of my eyes. See, this is, you'd think you'd be able to see that.
Can I ask some questions?
Yeah, of course you can. Ask away.
Why was the vinegar the choice to dislodge a bone?
Because it was all that was there. It was the fish and chip shops.
And in a fish and chip shop, they didn't have access to any, like,
soft cans of drink.
I thought I was going to die.
What does your dad do again?
He works in a steel factory. Why? Did you think that I made up a dad for this
No,
story?
No, I just don't think he invented scale electrics and then works in a steel factory.
I forgot about the scale electrics story.
I'm gonna say scale electrics is absolute bullshit.
I'm gonna be honest with you, I'm not quite sure what scale electrics is even. I know it's cars. that one's a lie, but then there's another lie, isn't there?
I do think you are someone who would drink a bottle of vinegar if in an emergency.
Thanks.
Vision-wise, I don't know.
I do.
I'm gonna say you can't see out of one eye.
That's true, I can't see about this one. Blind in this eye.
Well, I got one right.
Yeah, well done.
The scale electrics one was really bad. Okay, Izzy, you ready?
Yeah.
Okay. No eye contact, so I'm questioning everything you say already.
When I was born, I had white hair, but one in 200,000 babies has white hair, and then it falls out within about 6 months.
I believe that 110%.
When I was born, these are all gonna be when I was born, by the way. I had a kind of lump that pushed down one of my eyebrows, and it grew out of my head, and then it just sank into my head when I was two.
Okay, number three.
Okay.
What a weird baby. I'm sorry.
Yeah, one or the other.
Could you, like, what a prize. Okay, the third one. Okay.
By my second birthday, I could play the first 16 bars of Moonlight Sonata by Beethoven. It's the one that goes...
It's a lot for a baby with a lump that got reabsorbed. Okay, I think the lump and the piano are the lies.
The piano is a lie.
I knew it. Fingers.
The hair is a lie.
You had a lump you reabsorbed into your body? Hey, that was probably a twin or something. That's crazy.
If you looked closely, you could see a tiny face.
Do you ever
I was only joking.
It's going to pop up one day out the side of your neck.
I do sometimes think, oh, my God, what if it's, like, in my body and it'll just...
My dream right now is that it actually comes out whilst you're on Alan's show. Yeah, so no before news. The lump makes an appearance now, if I could just take a drink order for both of you.
I'd love to drink a Coke Zero or otherwise fizzy black fluid.
Just a fizzy black fluid. Amazing.
I would like a G&T and my lump would like a water. Oh, God, that sounds really weird.
No, I think that's perfect. Thank you so much for coming to Bauer's Bar. Enjoy, Alan. Have fun.
Thank you.
What is this?
Mystery ingredients.
Yeah.
It's a mystery. Wie eine Kinderüberraschung, I.
Zwei, bitte. Yeah.
I can't tell you what it is, but I can tell you that you've crushed it. I will say that.
It'll be some powdered gland.
No.
I know it will.
And if it was, you'd love
it. I absolutely drink that down.
What's your dream snack, though, if it wasn't something you were showing off?
I'm carbs all the way. I don't really care. If it's white, if it's made of something refined, yeah, there's nothing wrong with it.
Thank you.
I used to come home from school and eat an entire, you know, nimble bread, that stuff that you can compress to a thumbnail size.
What's nimble bread?
It's mainly air. Although, if anyone is looking from the Nimble group for sponsorship, it's also great bread.
Really?
For sure. I come from Croydon. This is
no, you're not a Croydon. Yeah. I literally dropped that in shock. Would you not see Croydon for you?
Yeah.
What did you see? I thought Surrey.
Well, Croydon technically is Surrey.
Okay.
North. Okay. Very, very north urban Surrey.
I'm from Fleet. Do you know Fleet?
Oh, I do. I've gone passed at speed.
You're welcome.
You're welcome. This is a one. It's not your first rodeo, is it, this?
Well, I actually served you in a bar before, so this feels very weird for me.
This is 10 years ago.
It'll be some dungeon beer keller.
No, it was not a beer keller. It was the National Theatre.
Oh, darn.
And I was working front of house, and I served you a drink. And you were very lovely, which just makes me very excited to make this for you now.
Well, but I must have been having a good day.
Kate, can you try it, though? And yeah. I want you to tell me what you would call it and give it a rating of 1 to 5. But no, I tried really, really, really hard, and I've got very sensitive feelings.
I'm going to love it.
Promise?
I promise you.
Paused. Paused. I'll have the tiny remaining bit.
Paused. The first thing that comes to mind vis-a-vis the naming is the de-enamelizer, because that's just stripped the Nashes right back to almost peg status.
I genuinely thought
it'd be... That's a lot of acid, isn't it? High on the acids. I might call it the wound sterilizer, because I think it's got a really deep antiseptic property.
There's chalk over there. Would you mind putting it on Bauer's bar?
This was not a...
You have to walk. I'm sorry.
Not used chalk since I was in prison.
And a 5 out of 5.
A 5 out of 5 from the Perkins.
Oh, my God. Yes! Just
is that it?
That's it. I can hang
for days.
And you can now enjoy your wound sterilizer.
Do you know what?
The 5 out of 5.
I've come back for more.
Well, 5 out of 5, take it with you. Take it on the show. Are you looking forward to the show?
What show? Yes, of course I am.
Good luck.
I'm leaving now and taking this bucket of weirdness with me.
Dankeschön.
Wiedersehen.
Auf Wiedersehen.
Wiedersehen.
Tschüssi. Let us know who you'd like to visit Bauer's Bar next week in the comments. And don't forget to subscribe to Dave and hit that notification bell so you don't miss out on all of our fresh content. And head over to UKTV Play to watch all episodes of Alan Davies As Yet Untitled for free.